In the 1930s, there was a preacher named Alfred Ackley. During a time of evangelistic meetings he was holding, a young Jewish student asked the question, "Why should I worship a dead Jew?" Using the scripture to witness him, Pastor Ackley began to explain to this young man how that Jesus was alive. "He lives, I tell you, young man. He is not dead, but lives here and now. Jesus Christ is more alive today than he ever was before. I can prove it by my own experience, as well as the testimony of countless thousands." The thought of a resurrected Savior was on his thoughts after that conversation. As he prepared for his first Easter sermon, the thought became ever more present. On that resurrection day, as he rose early to prepare, Ackley turned on his radio. He was then shocked to hear a liberal preacher say something like this, "You know, it really doesn't matter to me if Christ be risen or not. His body could have turned to dust long ago in some Palestinian tomb. Well, what's important is that his truth goes marching on." "It's a lie," Pastor Ackley yelled. He was worked up by what he had heard, and mixed with his continual thoughts of the scripture. "He lives, I tell you, he is not dead, but lives here and now." Ackley preached with great fervency, both that morning and evening, on the realization of our Lord's resurrection. Later that night, he still could not shake the question of that young Jewish student and the words of that liberal preacher. It was then that his wife encouraged him to do something about it. His wife said, "Why don't you write a song about it, and then maybe you'll feel better. Then you'll have something that will go on telling the story." Reverend Ackley, in telling the story later, said that he preached that Easter Sunday quite differently than he had ever preached before. But at the end of the day, he still felt that he had not yet said everything he wanted to say. He went to his study and again turned to the resurrection story and reread the words, "He is not here, for he is risen." He then began to write as the words flowed from him. In moments, he was at the piano adding music to the words he had been inspired to write. "I serve a risen Savior. He's in the world today. I know that he is living.